Hey, look at the picture behind me. It's Evan and I watching Taylor. So I wanted to explain how it came to be, how I became a Swiftie, this old dude like me. And at the end of the video, I'll talk about Evan and my epic night on April 2nd, 2022, when we listened to all 9 of Taylor's albums. Remember, at the time, Midnights hadn't been released, so there was 9 from debut to Evermore. So, how did I become a big Taylor Swift fan? So, in 2007, I was 32, and I heard Teardrops on My Guitar. And I was like, holy cow, this girl can write. How old is she? I think she was 17, maybe 16 at the time. And I was like, wow, she has an amazing craft to write. Well, at that time, I was Evan's nurse, and he was a huge country music fan. Let me see if I can. There we go. Huge country music fan, but I didn't know he was a huge Taylor Swift fan. And a couple years later, Evan went to see Taylor in Boston, her Fairless tour. But he had seen a lot of country artists at the time. And my love for Taylor's music kind of grew over the years. But I wasn't fully aware, like I said, that Evan was a Swiftie until years later, 1989 came out. And my family, we bought him 1989 for Christmas. And I started playing it, and every single time he smiled. Even on his worst days, he smiled. And I realized, wow, he really likes this girl. And over the years, when technology became more convenient and his mom got him a smart TV, we started watching videos on like YouTube on his television. And we'd play all kinds of artists, and every time we came to Taylor, he would smile, even on his worst days. And I realized, this guy's a huge Taylor Swift fan. And at that time, we became Swiftie buddies. And we were Swiftie buddies till the day he died. And it was a tradition, we'd watch a Taylor Swift concert at night together. And then when he'd wake up in the morning, I'd play him a Taylor Swift album. And like I said, that was a tradition for years. And I miss those days so much. So how did it come to be on April 2nd, Saturday, 2022? So his mom messaged me on Friday to tell me that he was not doing well. Oh, back up. So I wasn't even supposed to work that weekend, but a couple nurses left a couple months before, and Deb had all these open nights. So about a month before that, I picked up this 4-day weekend. It wasn't a 4-day weekend. I picked up Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Normally I work Monday and Tuesday. So I picked up Saturday and Sunday. And she told me Friday morning, Evan was barely hanging on. So I went to see him to say goodbye. And he stayed alive. And he stayed alive. And then Saturday night I came in and he was just hanging on. So I'm like, Evan, we're gonna do an epic night tonight. I didn't think he was gonna make it through the night. And we started going from the beginning, which is debut. And the goal was to get to Evermore. And this is how it went. So we started debut. I had to get my initial beginning of the shift done. And I knew I would need about 10 hours to pull off all 9 albums. So I think we started debut maybe around 8 p.m. And I knew I had about 11 hours to pull this off. And he was hanging on, so we just kept going. And by the way, our song is his favorite song off of debut, and it's the top 5 for him. So we got to Fearless Taylor's version at about 9:30. And I was really concerned about Taylor's version of Fearless and Red Taylor's version because they're about 2 hours long. And I was really concerned we were going to make it through. So we got to Fearless Taylor's version, like I said, about 9:30. And he was struggling. Huge bouts of apnea where he wasn't breathing, but he just kept going on. And we got to his favorite song, You Belong With Me. And we made it through Fearless Taylor's version. Speak now. So let's see, it must have been about 11:30 when we got the Speak Now. Speak Now is Evan's favorite Taylor Swift album. I love Speak Now. And he just kept holding on. It's like he wanted to make it through this epic night. And we made it through Speak Now. Red Taylor's version. So we're, I think we're past midnight at this point. And Red Taylor's version is the longest one of the Taylor's versions at that time, because 1989 and Speak Now Taylor's version hadn't been released. So I knew this was gonna be like a 2-hour process, and we just kept going. And he just kept holding on. And we were closing in on the middle of our run of albums. We made it through Red. Next, we know what's next. It's 2 a.m. We made it to 1989. The album that made us Swiftie buddies together. And he, I don't know how he was holding on. I really don't. I really think he was holding on for me. So we made it to 1989, 2 a.m. Amazing. We made it to Reputation, 3 a.m. At this point, I had a really sense of urgency, like, come on, buddy, let's get through this. And this, the stress of, I didn't want my best buddy to pass away. And he just kept holding on. So 3 a.m., Reputation. Yeah. We made it to Lover. We made it to Lover. Oh. And it's so hard to explain how sick he looked. And it blew me away that he was holding on. And we made it to Lover. So it's like 4 a.m. now. It's 4 a.m. It's like, really? I was getting really anxious. Like, come on. We almost made it through. 2 albums to go. Okay. Made it to Lover. We made it to Folklore. It's 5 a.m. I know I have just enough time to get through the next 2 albums. It was so important. It meant so much to me, making it to Folklore. Because this song, this album, was so therapeutic for him on those bad days when he was having massive seizures. Folklore would calm him down and your seizures would gradually subside. So it meant so much to me that we made it to Folklore. One album to go. We made it. We made it to Evermore. All 9 albums in one night. We made it. Evermore was just as important to Evan as Folklore. It was so therapeutic to him on his bad days. And remember, this is Sunday morning. I don't know how he made it, but he did. And it was one of the greatest moments I've ever experienced with my amazing friend. Evan would make it through all of Sunday, and we had Sunday night together. And then he would pass away Monday evening. So about 36 hours after us making it through all 9 albums. What a night. I did take pictures of him enjoying all 9 albums. So I'll finish this video with that. And I thank you so much for watching.